Independent human rights institutions for children are institutions established within the state system by law and publicly funded, whose role is to independently monitor children's rights and the actions of both the state but also actors in society towards the realization of the rights of children.
These institutions are very important because otherwise the rights of children would not be visible at all. They wouldn't be on the political agenda. Governments would pay little attention to these rights. And if you don't have such an institution, there would be no monitoring of what governments are doing. So an institution like mine, which is independent, makes a difference for children in a great way on the political scene and even on a day-to-day basis.
It's all about voices of children. Also, the voices not seen and heard in society, the vulnerable children, hidden away, not on the political agenda. That you have a mechanism, an entity, an ombudsperson, who can address their interest, bring them up for debate, and also urge government to make the situation change to the better.
The Committee on the Rights of the Child has emphasized the importance of establishing these institutions for the implementation of the Convention on the Rights of the Child.
One of the important things I think the Ombuds offices have to address, that is the fragmented machinery of the state. It's divided into Ministry of Health, Finance, Education. Children cannot be divided up in that. The Convention is stating that we should have a holistic approach to children and children's issues.
Independent human rights institutions for children are very fragile, and sometimes their existence even can be threatened. It can be threatened on various grounds. Some of them may be economic consideration, because in times of financial crisis and when investment priorities are being decided, the independent human rights institution for children may not be considered as an important element in the public system. Other grounds of fragility are political considerations.
In order to make sure that there is no risk of any kind of challenge of the institution itself, one must build alliances with the press, opinion leaders, children, NGOs. And if there is that kind of alliance, and if one is respected in a country where there's a high level of democracy, I doubt very much that it can be challenged.
The establishment of an independent human rights institution for children is a very complex process. It's not linear, and it's not that there is one recipe that works for any country. Each country will be different. What we see from the research that is critical is one, that the process be led by the government or the parliament, by a very strong political actor. It's very important that all parts of society be consulted and involved, because the independent institution will then have to work with all of them.
Another important thing with this of how the office should be run is that if you can make them understand that they are not only a reactive mode thinking, that we're just monitoring and we then stating something which is wrong, but at the same time they also have a proactive mode. They can see what's going to happen, they come up with a good proposal for governments, for politics, for media, for debate, public debate, how we can change the course.
An important element of the establishment process is that even though these independent human rights institutions for children have been promoted by international standards, it needs to be driven and owned nationally. Even if regional or international organizations can be involved as a convening power or as a supporter of these processes, in the end, it needs to be at the national level that the drive and the impetus is driven.
In order to set up such an institution, I think there is a great amount of consultation which must be done within the country with all actors, including government, and a lot of awareness on what this is going to bring and how it is going, in fact, to be important for children, but also important to the government itself, important to the whole state, important to everybody.